Welcome, Jason and Quinn. The two of you are going to tell us about our amazing new creator tools. So what do each of you do on the Minecraft team?
Yeah, thanks, Lydia. So I run the Minecraft Marketplace Partner Program.
Awesome. And Jason, what about you?
I am a developer on the Bedrock Platform team.
Awesome. Before we get into scripting, Quinn, what is Marketplace? Can you give us a refresher?
Yeah, totally. So the Marketplace is a great place where you can go and buy free, or buy, and there's also free content too. Skins, textures, worlds, mashups, all made by some of our amazing community creators across all of our Bedrock platforms.
That's awesome. And today you're going to tell us about scripting. So Jason, what is scripting for everyone in the audience?
Yeah, so scripting is a way for creators to add things to the game that the developers of the game didn't actually plan for. So we do a lot of cool things in add-ons where people are able to take behaviors from the vanilla game and mix them up in different ways and get cool things. But with scripting, they can do lots of stuff that you'd never see in the vanilla game.
That's amazing. And I heard you were quite inspired by Tnt, which is our partner in China, because they were doing some work on scripting. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so they had started doing some scripting several years ago, and they've got some stuff kind of in, and we're like, we have to have that. So we started hooking up. We've done some different tech directions, but it was definitely inspired by them.
It's awesome. So you have some things to show us with editor tools first. So let's take a look at some of the new editor tools you've added.
So this first one, this is called the editor stick. And what this allows you to do is it basically allows you to take any block and change any of its parameters. So you can go to the wool here and change it from being yellow to blue. And you can really change any of the different items. So here we can look at the wood, where you can change it from oak to birch. And it's a great way to, instead of having to replace that block, you can actually just go and change the parameters to be what you want it to be. So it saves a bunch of time. Another really big time saver here is you can go in and change the crops to be fully grown.
He just stole our beats.
Well, someone was very happy with that editor tool.
Maybe in the future we should get rid of the mobs before we set up the world.
So why is that important for creators to be able to move that process along faster?
Yeah, well, the great thing is sometimes you need to be able to, like, not just have to replace the block. Like, you have to take the thing out and put a new one in. Sometimes you're like, oh, I actually wanted this to be a different color, or I wanted this sign to be shifted a different way. It allows you to really quickly make those kind of small tweak modifications for like a polished pass on the map.
It's awesome. And give you a chance to try some different colors or different ways to see how it looks. But you also have some things that speed up the process significantly, which we can look at.
Yeah, so definitely in a lot of builds that creators make, they don't want to just do a single block by block change. And they want to do some much quicker stuff.
Let's look at some quicker changes.
Yeah, so here there's the TNT wand, where you can actually go and quickly remove large chunks of the world around you. Just kind of go through and make big holes. And it's a great way to kind of rough out an area and get it close to what you want, and then kind of come in and fine-tune it. And here's one that basically makes like a big hallway. So imagine how long that would take destroying block by block. And when you have these worlds, that sometimes they're like a kilometer by kilometer or much bigger, like this can be a huge time saver for them.
And sometimes if you don't want to go build a house block by block, you can actually go and make a TNT that does it for you. And here, this one's great too, because it's Minecraft. Like, this is a way to go and build your house in a very Minecrafty way. Instead of just replacing a thing where you place a block down and it automatically builds a house, it's a TNT block that explodes and makes it there for you. I really like this homey feel of this cabin.
That's a great cabin. It's way nicer than what I can build.
Yeah, me too.
It allows you, if you're scripting, then suddenly you could use those houses and put them everywhere for a build quite like significantly quicker.
Yeah, you can make a whole town pop up just by placing a bunch of TNT and lightening it with the redstone or something. It's a really fun way
to do it. Those editor tools are awesome. And you also have some tools that are helping with gameplay experiences.
Yeah, this is where I get most excited about the possibilities of scripting. Not just being able to make editor tools or things that make building faster, but being able to make things that are change the entire gameplay of Minecraft, and not just relying on the vanilla behaviors, but being able to make your own unique behaviors and gameplay mechanics. So this next clip will show a really, really cool way to take on that.
Yeah, so it is, so the creator here, he went and made his very quick rope bridge. So he made this cool, he made an item and you can actually just go through and just aim to another point and it'll just build a bridge for you automatically using the slabs from your inventory. Now, Endermen have always been able to teleport, but it's a very sort of random teleport. And this was an ability they went and made where you could actually aim at a point in the world and it'll actually cast you to that point and project you there. So it's a, kind of a superhero feel map. Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't just give you the ability to teleport, but also gives you this kind of like magic missile kind of mind blast that you can do to take out all those pesky skeletons that are shooting at you. And there's just, it adds this way that you can change the entire way that you can explore the world. So you can build a city and try and go save all the denizens of this city. And there's another feature of this one too, where there's this big shield that you can put up that blocks all the different arrows.
Very cool.
So there's a shield that kind of protects you for, what, 30 seconds
about
or something?
About 30 seconds, yeah.
So creators can use this to create all new and interesting game experiences for players.
Yeah. The possibilities are really endless.
And you have one other cool thing to show us with scripting. What is that, Jason?
Yeah, so we've been working on, Minecraft has had the ability to change skins for a long time. You can change the texture on your model. And as we'd kind of working on that, we were data driving a lot of parts of the game so creators could change things. And we made it so that creators could change more than just the texture of the player models. We wanted them to be able to change the actual 3D models, change the animations, add special effects to them, et cetera, et cetera. And stuff like that. So I have a video to kind of show off some of the stuff I personally built in this case. So I've been kind of, I'm a big fan of penguins. I think penguins are one of the coolest animals.
He's been wanting to add these to Minecraft forever, by the way.
Not yet.
So I quickly knocked out a penguin. They're not coming to Minecraft. But I knocked this out, and you can see he's got kind of custom animations. His arms kind of flap out, and he moves very different than Steve. And then I replaced the sprint animation with a fun little belly slide. And this was actually kind of a happy accident I wasn't actually planning for, but the sprint particles are kicking up, and it kind of helps sell the slide animation. So it's always fun when those happen as a developer.
So what kind of game are you hoping creators make with the data-driven player change?
Yeah, so while I was working on this, I kind of had this vision of, like, I want someone to go make a velociraptor where it goes around and eats something. It could be other players, it could be animals or something. And it's something, so please, community, build me a velociraptor game.
Velociraptor.
I don't have the art skills to make the velociraptor.
Your penguin was pretty cute, though.
Yeah, it was okay.
Quinn, any games you would like to request?
I just think, like, Velociraptor is cool, but I think a racing game where you could actually transform the player into a sweet car and have them be able to customize it and then have a bunch of animations of it like drifting around corners and stuff like that, I think that'd be super cool.
And the cars are penguins.
And the cars are all penguins.
Or velociraptors, I guess.
Why not both?
Penguins riding velociraptors.
So how can people experiment with scripting?
So it's actually available right now. So you can go download the Bedrock Edition and start messing around with scripting. There's a bunch of tutorials on the wiki and across the web that you can basically look at and try and mess around with it yourself.
That is amazing. Thank you so much, Quinn and Jason. Speaking of cool tech, as some of you might have heard, we have an exciting update coming to Minecraft on Windows 10. Ray tracing. As part of our partnership with NVIDIA, ray tracing will be coming soon and available for Minecraft on Windows 10 for DirectX capable GPUs. There's a lot to say there. Let's check it out. We'll be right back.